when you're on an out-of-state hunt and you're doing the scouting, you know, in the mornings before you go hunting in the evening or whatever the case may be, and you say you find good sign, how do you kind of determine how where to set up on that sign as far as like proximity to bedding? Is like you just picked out like this is probably where they're bedding on a map. I need to be within that distance.
Well, I generally go and look towards bedding. You know, I might look at a field edge, but if I do, it's adjacent to bedding. You know what I mean? I'm always got that bedding in the back of my mind. Mm-hmm. And I'm going and checking out areas that look like bedding on a map. First I drive by them. And if they still look that way, then I'll get out and I'll walk. But I'm looking at the wind and stuff, and I'm walking the downwind side, and I'm going into where I would set up. I'm creeping into the staging areas, basically. And if there's no sign, I just keep going. Or if the sign is, like, mediocre, I might just back out, go to the next spot. And if I don't find something better, I might go back to that spot. Or I might just keep walking until dark if I don't find anything, because the more time on foot, the better. But right. Oftentimes you'll find, you know, a spot that's, it's pretty good, but you don't know for sure. So you keep scouting and see if you find something better, and you don't, you go back to that. Or you find something else, and then you got to wonder, well, which one do I want? But you got to be careful, too, if the amount of property you have is limited, that you don't want to burn everything out in one day walking it. So if you find something pretty good, then maybe you got to stop looking. If you're relatively sure you're going to hunt it, you might want to just hunt it before you walk all the stuff and get your scent in there, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, there was a day last year when I was in Nebraska, I never set up. I just never found what I was looking for and kept scouting around. And all of a sudden it was, you know, whatever, an hour before dark. And I'm like, oh, screw it. I'm going to just keep scouting until dark. And if something happens to walk in on me or something, great. But
well, the good thing is, and I like this a lot, going on road trips. If you know somebody in the area, like you said, you know this guy down there, or you met this guy.
Yeah.
If he's a relatively decent hunter, he should be able to at least point you in the right direction.
Yeah.
I mean, everything he says might not be your cup of tea, but he probably knows the properties that have some good bucks on them. He knows where some have been shot, things like that. And he can kind of steer you in the right direction for that time of year if you're in a totally new environment. Usually I can kind of look at a terrain and figure most of that out, but it certainly doesn't hurt to have a little advice from somebody that's hunting in the area that knows what they're doing.
What I find valuable from him was I don't know if he's watching this or not, but you know, he was like reaffirming like what I was doing last year. I was really close to getting it figured out. He's like, yeah, what I really he thought the properties I picked were really good, but what I really gained a lot from him was like some local knowledge about like how to get into places that, you know, aren't real obvious to someone driving from out of state, and, you know, a parking lot here or there, or how to use the river or this or that. And also he like knows some of the landowners around those public spots where he was like, this guy here, you know, he's a hunter. He's not a hunter. They practice management on this farm. And, you know, he was actually real knowledgeable about that stuff. Or, you know, this guy over here is, you know, an idiot and runs all over the public land and you know, outfits on it and everything else, you know, and that stuff like that was really helpful from him. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people like act like, well, I shouldn't say act like, a lot of people don't want to have any like help from anybody, right, when they go anywhere, but
yeah,
like I don't know. It can be very valuable on being successful if you get some local knowledge somewhere.
I don't mind talking to people, but I don't like people telling me what tree to sit in or anything.
Well,
pointing me to a spot. I kind of want to do that on my own, but I often find it interesting to talk to people and kind of read them. And even if you're just talking to local people in parking lots and stuff, you know, you kind of read if somebody's being honest with you, or if they're trying to throw you off or.
Right. Yeah.
Or just, I think if I was in that area, I don't think that area cattails and stuff have caught on yet.
Yeah.
On the bet, if you found some marshes up there that don't have much for trees.
Yeah.
I'd be willing to bet you'd probably get into some stuff, especially if it's a marsh near crops.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good tip. I know of a spot like that. I just never made it. I scouted it last year. I just never made it back to it, kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And it was kind of, it was also corn. It wasn't beans last year. So this year it might be beans.
Yeah, well, so the beans by me are still green right now. So
oh, yeah. They should be in the roster too.
Just a matter of if there's oaks dropping, because right now I've seen a big shift in deer from our beans to our oaks.
Yeah.
The acorns are starting to drop.
I have a bunch of oak trees marked down there too to go check on.
Well, that's kind of why marshes and swamps might be something good to look at, because if you start getting into woodlots that are full of oaks, you're probably going to have a hard time finding deer because they're just going to be everywhere.
Right.
They're going to stand up in their bedding area and eat.
Yeah, so it'd be hard to get oaks, on. Yeah.
Oaks and marshes and oaks and swamps are usually isolated from the bedding in high areas. And mm-hmm. those bucks are going to come out of the bedding to those areas probably in daylight at that time of the year. So if there's a good acorn crop there, there sure is here.
Mm-hmm.
I would probably try to look for lowland areas that don't have a lot of oaks, but hunt oaks.
Hey, everybody. If you like the channel, make sure you subscribe right here. And if you like the clips, I got two more options for you. Two options right here. Subscribe right here. See you guys.